already being in the hospital, especially if you're older, if English is not your first language, if you're very sick and frail, already being in the hospital is at baseline a very stressful experience. And people can be prone to this thing called delirium, where their mental function, their mental status kind of waxes and wanes. It goes up and down. This can be prolonged for a really long time. And COVID has made this so much worse. It is awful. You basically now have that older, frail, non-English speaking person, put them in a room by themselves, no family visitors, difficult to access video interpreters. You can't see any of your doctors or nurses or physical therapists because they're wearing the full PPE. You could barely see their eyes. They're not coming in as often as they used to, perhaps. It's just a nightmare. It's a setup for getting worse in delirium. And this is a story in the New York Times from one of our UCSF patients who spoke to the New York Times about how terrifying these hallucinations and this delirium was. He says, quote, "They want to kill me." That's how he felt being in the ICU. And this is a very common experience with our patients who are hospitalized, particularly in the ICU, with severe delirium. And that can take a long time to recover from. And some studies show actually delirium can even increase your mortality. So how do we help in these situations, particularly with this importance of the mind-body connection? We have a very close relationship with our psychology and psychiatry colleagues, such that every single patient who comes to Optimal is seen by a mental health specialist. We talk a lot about reassuring people, listening to their fears, talking about coping strategies. We do a lot of peer support with that virtual support group through the Osher Center that I mentioned. We assess if they actually need, you know, medications for new depression, anxiety, PTSD, or therapy. We talk a lot, especially in the pre-vaccine era, about loneliness, about social isolation, about safe socializing and logistics around that, particularly for our older adults who are dealing with this. Dr. Parasinoto is one of our leading geriatrics researchers at UCSF who talks a lot about the science of loneliness in elderly folk and how this was made so much worse during COVID.